Hello students, I am Chef Umesh, Assistant Professor at Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today in this chapter we will be reading about types of knife. In our previous chapters we have learnt about basic knife skills, in which we read about the name of the parts of knife, and now we will be discussing them here today. In the previous chapter we also read about how to hold a knife and the different hand postures while handling a knife, their types and the safety measures that needs to be taken care of while working with a knife. Today we will be discussing about brief about knife, their introduction. We will identify the different types, their parts, we will discuss them here, and different uses of knife as per their design. In the end we will be covering about some materials which are used to prepare different types of knife. Before we move on to parts and discuss them, we must know that a knife is a tool with a cutting edge or blade which is often attached to its handle or a handle. Although in ancient times when handle was not discovered, knives were made with a single blade running through, but it was quite difficult to handle them while working with it. So with the advent of time and as the time passes by, human race designed knife as per their suitability and as per the use of handling them. One of the earliest tools, that is knife, is used by mankind after meat was discovered and the cooking methods were discovered. Knives appeared at least 2.5 million years ago. If we discuss about the various purposes of knives, hunters use them for hunting, soldiers use them in combat, scouts use them for camps and hikes, and similarly hikers carry a pocket knife, which is a different type of knife apart from kitchen knives. So there are kitchen knives for preparing foods like chef's knife, the paring knife, bread knife, cleaver, etc. Table knives, which are not meant for cutting vegetables but are used for separating butter or cutting butter into different sizes or different portions. Then there are steak knives. Weapons are also a category which comes under the knives itself. Daggers or switchblades are its example. Knives are also used by people in circus for throwing or juggling, and knives are also used in religious ceremony or for display purposes. Like in Sikh people, they keep kirpan, a sort of curved edge knife, with them as a display of their religion. Moving to the parts of knife, it starts with the tip or point, then comes a spine or the backbone of knife, handle, rivets, tang, bolster, heel and cutting edge. Now in the upcoming slides we will discuss all these parts in brief. So first we are going to describe what is tip, its use, spine and cutting edge. So tip is something which is curved or flat as per the design of knife. Typically tip is used for carving or cutting small pieces of food, and sometimes for piercing the vegetables or meat. Then comes the cutting edge, which is the most important and the sharp part of a knife, which actually does the cutting work. Different edges or different cutting edges have different purposes. Like in serrated knife, those are used for cutting different vegetables like tomatoes, breads, etc. However, plain edges are used to cut meat and other products. Spine, also known as backbone of knife, is usually wider than the blade and is blunt to keep the user hazard harm free, because a two-sided blade or two-sided cutting edge can also harm the user and will be quite difficult to use a knife while working. In our previous chapter we have read about the different postures you use the knife and the different grips. Here comes the use of a spine or a blunt spine, which also helps to grip the knife. Larger the knife, thicker will be the spine. It is more often. However, nowadays designers are making knife which are quite thinner in the spine area also. Then comes heel and bolster. Heel is the last edge of the knife which is used for cutting, or we can say the last point, the last point of the cutting edge is known as heel. However, bolster is the point, or can be said a junction between the handle and the knife. Here is a brief description of heel, which says that the heel is the very back portion of the blade edge. In bigger knives, heel can be up to about 2 inches of the blade. The smaller the knife, the smaller the heel gets accordingly. The heel is used to cut food that need a little extra force to be cut. Because it's designed as a heel is meant to be at the end part of the cutting edge, more force can be applied with the help of hands or with the help of grip while cutting thicker pieces of meat or thicker vegetables. Bolster, being a junction point, also serves as a balancing purpose. It is a point where blade becomes thick at the very end before the handle starts. In the end, we are going to read about handle, rivets and tang. As it can be seen in the diagram, handle is usually the grip of a knife. Rivets are the nuts and bolts which keeps handle and tang joined together. Tang is also a part of knife blade which goes from bolster to the bottom, and it sits inside the handle itself. Sometimes to make a knife lighter in weight, the tang is only kept to the half of the handle. Handle, as we have already known, that it is a part of knife that we grip, and that helps our hand to properly hold a knife. But it is also a part of knife that houses the tang. Essentially, a handle allows you to grasp the tang so you can use the knife. Then comes rivets. These are metal pieces like nails or screws that hold both the handle and the tang at the same point. On some knives, these rivets are visible. However, when we design a knife for a fine dining restaurant or for a senior chef, it might be possible that we would keep these rivets underground or under the handle of the knife itself, or we can cover it with some other material. Now coming to the different types of knife, firstly we will go with the chef's knife or a all-purpose knife. Its length is 8 to 12 inches long if we count it from tip to bolster. It is the most commonly used and popular knife. It has a strong weighted blade. It is used for multi-purpose, as I already told you guys. Then it is used for cutting, chopping, slicing tasks, and that is the reason it is a staple piece in our kitchen collection. Then comes paring knife, which measures 3 inches to 4 inches from tip to bolster or the cutting edge length. It is a perfect everyday knife with a fine blade, slim cutting edge and firm tip. It is majorly used for peeling potatoes, fruits, vegetables and for carrying out other small intricate tasks such as scoring. Nowadays, a different type of knife or a different type of tool known as vegetable peeler or a fruit peeler has also been immersed in the markets, which makes it quite easier to peel the vegetables without harming us, or with very less effort. Then comes the turning knife, which is 2 inch to 4 inch long. It has a curved blade which is used for specific function, like it is featured on this style of knife, makes it perfect for peeling all kinds of fruits and vegetables. The short handle of this knife and the thin blade and thumb tip are also ideal for removing eyes from the potatoes and sometimes fluting the mushrooms. For your information, fluting is a design or a cut on done on mushrooms to give it eye appeal. Then there is another knife known as boning knife. As the name suggests, it is used for boning or skinning out or separating out the flesh from the bone. It has a curved edge. Its length is 5 to 7 inches. It features a straight edge designed to remove meat from the bone quickly and easily. Then it is made up of such a material that its blade is quite flexible and it helps to make it easy to de-skin or separate bone from the meat in fish and poultry. Then comes filleting knife, which is 8 to 15 inches long. This long slim blade is perfect for filleting and preparing fish and meat. The flexibility in the blade allows ease of movement and it makes delicate tasks such as removing the skin quick and effortless. Cleaver. Please do not confuse with a Chinese chopper. Cleaver is a knife which is commonly used in large kitchens and it is also large in size with a rectangular blade and incredible strength or a very strong metal. The thick cutting edge makes this knife perfect for tough tasks such as splitting large cuts of meat and spear. As I discussed that Chinese choppers are different from cleavers, however design is a bit similar. But Chinese choppers are used to chop, as the name suggests, or break bones or cut frozen foods. Instead, they are used for slicing purposes. Here we have a diagram which shows a Chinese chopper. We can easily identify a cleaver from a Chinese chopper. Like a cleaver's design is a bit curved, however a chopper is majorly near to a rectangle. It is used for slicing different vegetables and fruits. Usually Chinese chefs use it for all purposes and it is their all-purpose knife or it is a Chinese chef's knife. Then comes serrated blade knife, which is known as bread knife. It is long and strong, which allows to cut through bread, producing clean slices without any ripping or tearing. They are also used to cut some soft foods such as tomatoes and some juicy vegetables, which might release juice if we chop them or cut them with other knife. Then comes a palette knife, which is not actually a knife which is used for cutting, however it is used for picking up food or checking our omelets bottom and turning up pancakes. This is a broad and blunt blade as knife, and this type of knife, as I said, is great to use while cooking omelets and pancakes. As it is made up of flexible material, it allows us to slide it between the pan and the food with ease. Then comes santoku knife or a Japanese knife, which is similar to a chef's knife or an all-purpose knife, but majorly it is used by Japanese chefs. It measures 5 inches to 8 inches when we talk about its blade. It is excellent for cutting meat, fish and vegetable preparation. This particular knife has a wide blade to scoop chopped food and a curved end to help the rocking motion when chopping. It is also known as a Granton's knife or a ship's foot shaped blade knife, as it is obviously mentioned or it is visible in the diagram that it resembles a sheep's foot. There are some other knives which are used for different other purposes or by different chefs in different parts of world. Here we have a diagram showing us a Mezzaluna knife, which is a two-handled knife with one or more crescent-shaped blades which is used for chopping or mincing vegetables. Then comes crinkle or bundle knife, which is used for cutting fancy cuts of vegetable, as visible in the diagram. Like it gives them a zigzag shape, so that when we grill it or cook it in a griddle, it would give them a distinct design. Cheese knife, which has spaces or holes in it so that when we cut our cheese, it doesn't get vacuumed inside or stick inside. Then there is a kitchen axe, which is used for breaking bones or cutting harder pieces or bigger pieces of meat. If we talk about knife material, it is usually made up of stainless steel, which is least expensive and easily available. Then a better version of it comes, which is known as carbon steel, which is quite easier to sharpen and it is light in weight. Many of the chefs are using titanium steel knife nowadays because it is good. When we talk about its strength, it is corrosion resistant, lightweighted, and mixed with ceramic and silver to give it extra strength. Similarly, Damascus steel, which is old out from the Damascus region of southern Europe. This steel knife has a razor sharp edge, carbon steel core with steel covering tempered for a longer duration or to give it an extra strength. When we talk about sharpening, a knife is always should be sharpened with the help of a whetstone or a kitchen stone, which helps to sharpen it. However, after sharpening a knife in a whetstone, we can work with a sharpening steel to keep its edge from getting blunted very soon. This diagram shows how we should take care of our whetstone and how should we keep our knife's position to sharpen it. So first of all, we'll put our whetstone in water and make it wet. Then we'll prepare a base for it so that it doesn't get skidded or skid when we sharpen our knife. Keep the knife blades in between the angles of 10 degree to 20 degree and then make a hole length slide from one side and then turn it to the other side and make another hole length slide to other side. This thing can be repeated for 10 to 20 times and we need to check it again and again by cutting a tomato or a paper. This diagram shows how a steel sharpening rod or a steel should be used. As you can see, the chef is sharpening it against the steel at a distinct angle, which is obviously 15 to 20 degrees Celsius, 20 degrees. With this slide, we would end our today's topic, that is types of knife. For any queries, you may reach out to me at my email ID umesh.jugran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.